Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 5.1, Problem 4. This is Section 5.1, Problem 4. It says, find the simple interest rate needed for $400 to grow to $450 in 18 months. So because the problem mentions simple interest, I'm going to use the simple interest formula, I equals PRT, again, as opposed to the compound interest formula. In this section, it's got to be one of those two formulas. Now, as I fill this in, I is the interest earned. Now, for $400 to grow to $450, you must have had $50 of interest, right? That's how much interest you would need to make 400 grow to 450. Equals P, the principal or initial amount, that's the 400, that's how much you would have to put in. Times R, the rate as a decimal. Now that's the unknown, so I'm going to leave that as a variable. So I'm going to have 400 times R times T, the time in years. Now 18 months has to be put in as 1.5 years. 18 months is a year and a half. Now if you put 18 in the formula will think you want it in 18 years, and you get a very, very different answer. Now, I happen to know off the top of my head that 18 months is a year and a half, but if you don't happen to know that, just do 18 months divided by 12 months per year, and your calculator can do the work for you. Just enter 18 divided by 12 like that, and it'll tell you that it's 1.5 years. That's where you get the value for T, the time in years. Now, as you multiply the values on the right side of the equation, the left side is still 50, and on the right you have 400 times R times 1.5. Well, the 400 times 1.5 you can do, and again, I happen to know that that's 600, and if you don't, the calculator will do it for you. So I have the equation 50 equals 600 R. So now to solve for R, you want to divide out the 600. So I'm going to have 50 over 600. On the left side of my equation, equals R. So now, that's not something that most people would reduce easily in their head. So with your calculator, you want to enter the top of that fraction first. 50 divided by 600, it equals, and I just happen to be good at reducing fractions, it should be 0.08, and then the threes should continue forever. Now, when you have a situation like this, instead of writing so many threes in the dot, 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 the standard notation in any math class is just put a line over the decimal that repeats. That means it never ends. So you can write your answer as R equals 0.083 with the bar over the 3, and that's the correct answer. Or if you prefer percents, because some people like to think of the rate as a percent, you can say that is 8 1/3%. Either answer is completely acceptable. That's the rate you would need to make $400 grow to $450 in 18 months as a simple interest rate. Compound interest would be a different answer.